are thinking of starting a high-quality airline, but we don't have the quantity of money required. What cost-saving measures could we take?
How much are trains?
Say you still wanted to go in the airline business.
How much would it cost to put wings on a train?
There are driverless trains, perhaps don't have pilots or stewards.
Gliders.
Right, why?
No fuel costs.
Well, it is fuel that we want to save. We want to help the environment, you want to save money and so on. So here's an extraordinary thing.
No passengers.
Well, you want the passengers...
Or luggage.
You want the passengers to be as light as possible.
Skinny people with no bags. Are you allowed to advertise that?
Yes. In 2013, Samoa Air were the very first airline to charge passengers according to their own weight.
Really? Yeah, they did it.
Yeah, they had to pay one Samoan thalers, that's roughly sort of 29, 30p, for every kilo that they and their luggage weighed.
Wow.
But the actual plane, you can save money on the actual plane. I know it sounds very strange, but white planes are more efficient than dark planes.
What?
Lighter paint is literally... lighter. Dark paint on an aeroplane can add the equivalent weight of 8 passengers. You look, James, as though you don't believe me.
Well, it does sound like a lie.
Why might dark paint be heavier, do you think?
Because it's evil.
Dark paint is heavier because it has more pigments.
More pigments.
Yeah.
I was going to say pigment.
I was going to say pigment.
All right, children. All right. So, if you look at a plane, you'll see most of them are of a lighter colour.
Why paint it at all?
So that is the other option, is that you could polish it. However, you do need to wash it more often to offset corrosion, if you've just polished it. And white paint would be cheaper because, actually, the money you'd save on fuel, you'd spend on washing. So those are your
It sounds like choices. A headache, really. I'm not going to open an air flight business.
Are you not? But it's amazing where you can save money. So in 2018, United Airlines switched to lighter paper for the in-flight magazine, all right? They saved 1 ounce per copy. Doesn't seem like very much at all. But it's £11 saved for a full flight. You multiply that by the whole fleet over a single year, you have saved 170,000 gallons of fuel worth $290,000, just a single ounce of paper on each individual in-flight magazine. The airline's beverage cart, it now weighs half what the old ones used to weigh. They've stopped duty-free sales in many instances.
Well, I've picked a few already you can get rid of. That little tiny tray that the other trays are in,
yes.
Why does that exist? I mean, all of the food can go because it looks shit.
I noticed on a flight I was on recently that they weren't showing Ocean's 11, but they were showing Ocean's 8, so that's three people.
That's so. Three straight away. In the 1980s, there was a man called Robert Crandall. He was then head of American Airlines, and he removed just one olive from every single salad served to their customers. Nobody noticed, and they saved $40,000 a year.
Yeah, but I bet he was fatter at the end of it. If he's popping an olive from everyone's plate in every plane, that's having some effect. I'm no scientist.
No, clearly.
You could say, no hats. No one could really get annoyed if he said, no hats.
There's a lot of screws in a plane as well. I reckon a couple of those...
The Japanese airline called All Nippon Airways, in 2009, they asked passengers to visit the loo before boarding. They calculated that a full 767 could hold 240 pounds of urine inside its passengers. And if everybody boarded with an empty bladder, they calculated they could reduce carbon emissions by 5 tonnes over the course of a month.
Is that man doing a selfie while he's there?
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.